Mister,
By the name of Allah, yes.
you know, start decision.
What?
You start the decision now.
We started now, just right now, Hamad.
Okay.
Hamad, where are you, Hamad? What's your name here?
I'm Hamad Abdullah. My name
I
is
know, it's not, it's not here. This is only. You are in queue, your name in the Zoom?
No, this before. This before I give it to better now.
Okay, now okay,
You
guys.
said that.
Okay, let's start. Remember, guys, this is chapter review about chapter 10. We done this chapter already, we finish it. Okay, and make a review or revision about this chapter and be careful. There are many worksheets about chapter review with their answers already in the school website, and I will send it to WhatsApp group. Okay, so it'll be available on both school website and WhatsApp group. And remember, you have a live quiz,
What?
a live quiz in the school website. Okay, the deadline with this quiz, it will be on this Sunday. You have about 3 or 4, more than 3 days. Starting from today, it will be 4 days. Okay?
This is about chapter one.
Like, what if I answer it
About
tomorrow?
chapter what?
The
Chapter.
school website quiz. There are a quiz in the school website about this chapter.
Teacher, so
Okay?
it's like a normal homework, but it's a quiz.
A quiz, yeah. But I will record the results. It will be added to your report. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. You can study hard before going to the quiz. Study today, tomorrow, after tomorrow.
Where
Okay?
is
All the
the
time that you need the
you
school
will put
time.
work?
Okay. Let's start with our revision now. Okay? Okay. The first part of our revision, page 784, estimate each product. Estimate means you have to find another one. Here, 3 out of 4 times by 23. Okay, I have in denominator here 4, right? And the whole number is 23. Which number closer to 23 and divisible by 4? Which number closer to 23 surrounded to and divisible by 4? Which number, which is, yes, 24. Okay, I have to round 23 to be 24, multiply by 3 out of 4. Now I can simplify. So I can simplify 24 with 4. Divide both of them by 4. 4 divided by 4 equals 1. And 24 divided by 4 equals 26. So the answer will be 3 times by 6 over 1. 3 times by 6 equals to 18. 18 over 1 equals to 18. So the answer is about 18.
Teacher, why you do with the pen with 4 and 24?
Because 4 and 24, there are a common factor between 4 and 24. Both of them divisible by 4. So I divide each one of them by 4. 4 divided by 4 equals 1. 24 divided by 4 equals 6. Okay?
Can you tell me the lesson again? I didn't.
Teacher, I don't understand it.
Okay, again, estimate means you have to round. Okay, I have 3 out of 4 multiplied by 23. Okay, I have denominator is 4. Is 23 divisible by 4? No. Find another number closer to 23 and divisible by 4, which is I have 24. So I have to round 23 to become 24. So I have to multiply 3 out of 4 multiplied by 24. Now I can simplify 4 and 24 because both of them divisible by 4. So 4 divided by 4 equals 1, 24 divided by 4 equals 6. And now I have to multiply 3 multiplied by 6 equals to 18 over 1 means 18. Okay? Number 10, the same way. I have to estimate 1 out of 5 times by 22. I have the denominator is 5. Is 22, is 22 divisible by 5?
No.
No. Find another one. Okay. Yeah. Can you explain again, Khalid Somali? Okay. Be attention with number 10 to be the same. Okay, Khalid? In number 10, I have 1/5 multiplied by 22. The denominator here is 5. And the whole number is 22. Is 22 divisible by 5?
No. This
question for all of you. Is 22 divisible by 5?
No.
22 divisible by 5? No. So I have to round 22. Okay, which is closer to 22.
20.
Yes, excellent. So I have to change 22 to be 20. So I have to rewrite it like this. 1/5. Multiply by 20. What I did now, I round it. I round 22 to becomes 20. Now I can simplify 20 with 5, because both of them divisible by 5. 5 divided by itself equals 1. 20 divided by 5 equals what?
4.
4. 4. So I have to multiply 1 multiplied by 4 equals 4. 4 out of 1 means 4. So the answer is 4. You understand, Khalid, now?
Yeah, I understand.
Okay, and then.
Yes, I understand.
Okay, now we are going for next one. Multiply and write the simplest form. Yes?
I don't math hand just that.
Okay, here I have to estimate. Estimate means you have to round before multiply. Have 1/5. Multiply 22. 1/5 has a denominator is 5. And the whole number is 22. Is 22 divisible by 5 or not?
No.
Okay.
No. No.
You have to round 22. Which number closer to 22 and divisible by 5, which is?
20.
So I have to estimate it. It means you have to round. So I have to round 1/5. Multiply 22, we round it to be 20. And now I can simplify as a normal. 20 and 5, both of them divisible by 5. So I have to divide 5 by 5, it would be 1. And 20 divided by 5, it would be 4. So I simplified 5 and 20 by divide each one of them by 5. Now I have 1 multiply 4 equals to 4. Out of 1 means 4. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Now go for next one, number 11. Multiply right and simplest 4.
Mr. Rahino, can I answer?
Yes, wait for then. Abdullah, Hamad Abdullah, the answer is 7. You are right, Abdullah. You are right, Hamad. Excellent. This is the right answer. Can you explain for then?
Okay.
Okay.
3 multiplied by 21 equals 7.
Yes, equals 7. Now, I can make a whole number as a fraction by make it over 1. Now, I can simplify normally. So, I can simplify 3 and 7. 3 and 3 and 21, both of them divisible by 3. 3 divided by 3 equals 1. And 21 divided by 3 equals to 7. So the answer will be multiply now denominator with numerator. 1 multiplied by 7, which is 7 and denominators. 1 minus by 1 equals 1.
Teacher, so 7
over questions? 1 equals 2, 7. Yes?
The quiz, how many questions?
About 10.
What?
Okay. 10 questions. 10 questions. Okay.
Quiz.
Ahmad, you understand?
Yeah.
Good.
And Mr. How quiz?
The quiz must be 10. Okay. 10 questions about this revision.
Mr. I didn't understand the question 11.
11, again. 21 is a whole number. I can write it as a fraction by making it out of 1, as you see.
Mr. Page, what?
784.
Teacher, is it only from this page?
These 3 pages, this page and next page.
I study them.
Yes. Okay. Here, the one who asked about number 11, the whole number as a fraction will be 21 over 1. And then I can simplify 3 and 21. Both of them divisible by 3. So I can divide both of them by 3, divide each one of them by 3. 3 divided by 3 equals 1. 21 divided by 3 equals 2, 7. Now I can multiply numerator with numerator. 1 multiplied by 7 equals 7, and denominator 1 times by 1 equals 1. So 7 out of 1 means 7. Okay? Number 12, it will be the same. 26, the whole number, it will be 26 out of 1. And I can simplify if there is any common factor. Common factor between 26 and 2 is 2. So I can divide 2 by 2 equals 1. Yes, I will see the chatting. And 26 divided by 2 equals to 13.
This is easy, boy.
Yes, 13 multiplied by 1 equals 13, and 1 times by 1 equals to 1, so 13 out of 1 would be 13.
Huh?
Okay, I will see the chatting. Someone has a question, maybe will answer. Yes, 13, number 2, you are right. Excellent. Excellent, Khalid Somali. He wrote the answer.
Excellent. I don't understand it. No.
It's clear, Hamad? Is it clear?
Yeah, but like one more. From the start, I didn't understand.
Okay, now you understand? Number 15, normal fraction by fraction. Okay? As we learn, here I have to multiply 1, multiply 3 out of 5. If there is any common factor between numerator and denominator, there's any common factor? There is no common factor. So I have to multiply directly. Numerators. 1 multiplied by 3 equals what? 3. And denominators. Yes, Abdelaziz. 5 times by 8 equals?
5 times by 8.
Equals what? 4. So the answer will be 3 out of 4. Already simple. Okay?
It's up.
Yes?
I am now Excellent. Come. Can you explain for me?
Who's this? Fahad?
Yeah.
Okay, all Fahad.
Good.
Fahad, how to multiply fraction with fraction? That's normal. 1 multiplied by 3 equals 3. Numerator. And then multiply denominators. 5 times by 8 equals 40. There is any common factor here? There is no common factor. So the answer will be 3 out of 4.
How come, teacher, how common factor?
This 3 in table 3. There is any number in table 3 multiply give you 40?
No.
There's no any common factor.
Okay, so but teacher, number 11, how... you answer it.
Okay, 21 means 21 over 1. And there is a common factor between 3 and 27 and 20. 3 and 21, the common factor is 3. So I have to divide each one of them by 3. 3 divided by 3 equals 1. And 21 divided by 3 equals to 7. So I have to
okay.
Multiply 1
okay.
by 7 7, 1 times 1 equals 1, 7 out of 1 equals 2.
Yes. We put it in the simplest form.
Yes. Okay. Now, number 14, 1 out of 4, sorry, 1 out of 2 means 1/2 times by 7 out of 8. I can multiply first and then simplify, or simplify and then multiply, as you like. Here I can multiply. 1 multiplied by 7 equals 7. And 2 times by 8 equals 16. So the answer will be 7 out of 16. There is any common factor between 7 and 16?
No.
Already in simplest form, right.
Already in simplest form.
Yes, number.
Teacher, it will come same number or no?
Yeah.
Same.
Yeah, same numbers.
Teacher, what if someone is stuck in question? What do you do?
What?
What if someone is stuck in a question? What he do?
Okay, he can go back for the questions in the book and study it and then solve it again.
That's not
cheating. What I study for the quiz?
This pages. What we study now?
It will come same numbers, guys.
Yes. It will be the same number.
784
Mister,
only.
Mister, can I answer?
Yes, 784, 785.
Mister, I am. Can I answer?
Which one, number 15?
Yeah.
Okay, I think this was them, right?
Yeah.
Okay, my best friend. Okay. Can I answer? Let me ask someone. Maybe he is leaving. Amir, Mishali. Abdulaziz al-Hadri, guys, where are you? Khalid Somali. Where are you guys?
Teacher, ask me, teacher.
Okay, can you answer number 15? Sorry, Fawzan.
Okay.
Okay, Amir, can you answer number 15? Okay. Amir?
Yes.
Can you answer number 15?
Yes.
Okay, tell me. I have mixed number multiply fraction.
Yes.
That change mixed number to be fraction, right?
Yes.
How?
I make three over one.
No, not like this.
I know.
Yeah, to keep the fraction with the fraction mixed, the denominator is four. Keep it and then multiply the denominator by the whole.
Yes,
13.
By 3 equals 12.
And then
add the denominator. Add the one, it will be 14,
13. 13, you remember now. 13, yes.
Over, yes.
So 13 over 4. And then multiply by the other fraction.
3
over 5.
Yes. There is any common factor?
No.
Between?
No.
Okay.
Teacher, there is.
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
No.
So I have to multiply.
Four times 5 equals 20 and 13 times 3 equals
29.
Equals what? 39.
13.
And then I make it mixed number because how many 20 and 39, there's only one.
Yes,
divided by 2.
Yes, and the remainder is 19.
Yes.
So 19 over 20 over 21 and 19 over 20.
Teacher, how did we get it 1 or and 19 over?
How many 20 are there in 39? There's only one 20. I still have the remainder 19. So it'll be 1 and 19 over 20. Okay, now the number 16.
Can I have a time, please?
The number 16. Mixed multiply, mixed. Convert each mixed number to be
If teacher, if we are have 14.
What?
No, if we have 15, it would be a 10 or what?
If you have another number less than 12, less than 40.
Yeah, no, if we have 40, what we will
40 divided by 20 will be 2. If you have 40, yeah, for example, 40. This 40, 40 over 20 means 40 divided by 20 equals 2. Now number 16. Change the mixed number to be by keeping the denominator, multiply the denominator by 1. By 1. So I have to multiply. There's a sound. So I mute all. Keep denominator, multiply the denominator by the whole. 8 multiplied by 1 equals 8. Then add 8 plus 1 equals 9. So B 9 out of 8. Same way with the second, mix it, keep the denominator, which is 3, and multiply it by the whole. 3 multiplied by 3 equals 9, then add 9 to the denominator. 9 plus 2 equals to 11. Wait for that, please. There is any common factor between denominator and denominator? Yes, as we see here, 9 and 3, both of them divisible by 3. So I divide 9 by 3 equals 2. And divide 3 by 3, any number divided by itself equals to 1. There is no any common factor between denominator and denominator. So I have to multiply the remainder here is 3, multiply 11 equals to 33. And 8 multiplied by 1 equals to 8. Now, 33 divided by 8. There is 33 not divisible by 8. Go for something less than 33, which is 32. So 32 divided by 8 equals 4. And I have a remainder. You can subtract 32 from 33. I have a remainder 1 out of 8. So the answer would be 4 and 1 out of 8, as you see. Okay, anyone has a question? Okay. Fahad,
okay, question, teacher.
Yeah.
Why you write 9 and then?
Because multiply, I have a mix it. I change it to be in global fraction. By multiply the denominator, 8 by 1 equal 8, then 8 plus 1 equal 9.
Okay, teacher, why yes. You write the 11 and 3?
Because here I have 3 in denominator, we keep it, and multiply 3 by the whole. 3 multiply 3 equals 9, then add 9 to the denominator. 9 plus 2 equals 11.
Okay.
Okay, so what's your question?
You hear me?
Yes, I hear you now.
Okay, teacher, when you add the whole, why you did it, you added 8 plus 1?
No, I multiply 8 times by 1 equal 8. And then add 8 to denominator. 8 plus 1 equal 9.
And add 8 to that one?
Yes.
Oh, but what about the other one, the same?
8, multiply 3 by 3 equal 9. Then 9 plus 2 equal 11.
Now I understand this.
Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Chatting. I know I want to ask this. Okay, teacher, can you mute me? Unmute me. Who is this? Fauzan. Okay, Fauzan. Yes, what you have, coach?
What's up?
Yes.
And this to make how
question, what's your question, Fauzan?
Question 15.
Okay.
guess in the answer 1/19.
Yes.
1/19/20.
Yes.
Yes. The one from where you bring it?
Okay, 39. I have the answer is 39/20, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I can divide 39/20.
No.
No, because how many 20 are there in 29 and 39? Only I have 120. Means I have one. Tahu. And then the remainder, if we subtract 20 from 39, I will have 19. So one whole and 19/20.
Ah, okay. Thank you.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Any question?
No, thank you.
Okay.
No.
Okay. Next one. Divide. Write in simplest form. 2/1/6.
We change this to multiply.
Yes, change it to be multiply. Yes, very good. But, 2
multiplied by 6.
Yes, if we flip, 1/6 becomes 6/1. 6/1 means 6. So I have to multiply 2 × 6. It's called inverse operation. 2 × 6 equals 12. The answer will be 12. Okay? You understand it? All of you? You understand this?